Have you ever thought about building an airplane? It's no small task, and Zenith Aircraft offers potential builders the opportunity to try out the process before they commit to a full build. AOPA Live's Paul Harrop tried his hand at building a rudder.
We're going to see if I can make this out of this. I've always had an interest in home building, but it's been a space, time, and money equation that never worked out for me to try it. I've pulled exactly one rivet up until this point, the original one-week wonder in Oshkosh. The first thing you learn is to RTFM.
Cleco RR number 2 to the spar. Rudder rear rib number 2 is part number SD75R1-2. I'm going to guess it's the next one up in size, and that would be correct according to the material sheet.
It doesn't hurt to have a bit of professional advice. Zenith's Roger Dubert giving me some guidance.
Okay, this is the doubler.
Yep.
On top.
So like that. Okay, gotcha.
From there, there's just plenty of steps that take a bit of careful attention.
All right, with that, we've got one side of skin riveted on. We're ready to flip it in Cleco and rivet the other side. This is actually not as bad as I thought it would be. It's fun once you get into the rhythm of it.
In all, if you can read a material sheet, follow step-by-step directions, and work some basic tools, I am convinced you, like me, scary enough, can build an airplane.
All right.
Hooray!
Yay! All right, now we have a rudder assembly for a CH-750 Super Duty. Look at that. That looks like an airplane part.
You know, a few hours, you had a bunch of parts, now you've got an actual assembly.
Yeah. It's lightweight and strong and
awesome.
All right, now you got to sell me the rest of the kit and I got to put it together.
One step at a time, that's right.
In Mexico, Missouri, Paul Harrop, AOPA Live.